So Alex Grinch and Graham Harrell have been mentioned as candidates for the Colorado head coaching position, and it looks like Buffalo Brass gonna reach out to both of them, and we gotta talk about it after the bumper.
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You gotta help me with that corner shit.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step. Milk, consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always college football related, sports related. We have a good time. Today, we need to have a conversation about people are freaking out, man, about, well, Alex Grinch and Graham Harrell being possible candidates for the head coaching job. And I don't mean like a little bit of freaking out. I mean, people are really freaking out, man. Like, they are really in my mentions going, RJ, stop him. Hello? The phone line is down. Cut it, dude. We can't have this guy leaving OU. Which is the thing I totally get, because Alex Grinch took a defense that was ranked 118th in the nation and next to last in pass defense, flipped it around, cut Oklahoma by a touchdown. He was giving up 33.6 points per game in his first season. He dropped that number to 27, and that is without getting anywhere near the 24 takeaways he wants to see from his defense. Grinch did this at Washington State, with what everybody knows is a lesser talented team than the one that he even inherited at Oklahoma. He brought in a 2020 recruiting class that people are very excited about, with Bryson Washington, 6'2 defensive back, 6'3 Justin Harrington's going to join up. You also got guys coming in like Kendall Dennis out of Lakeland in Florida. You have a number of guys that actually are recruited to play in this kind of a scheme and this kind of a defense. And seeing what he was able to do in his first year has inspired many to believe that he can continue this kind of pace and what it might look like. Lincoln Riley actually equated what he did in 2015 to what Alex Grinch is doing in 2019, right? It's like we couldn't really sell it yet because people hadn't seen it. But when you saw what we were able to do in our first year, and then, hey, Lincoln was able to recruit to, he said, look, it got guys like Creed Humphrey, Hollywood Brown, CeeDee Lamb to buy into what they were doing. Guys like Trey Sermon. And then you saw what the 2018 offense looked like. You saw what the 2019 offense looked like. You saw what the 2017 offense looked like. We're talking about three straight college football playoff berths with half a defense in two of those years and kind of sort of a defense in that third year. And people are really wanting to see what Alex Grinch looks like once he gets his full class in. And that would be like 3 years from now. But now we've had Alex Grinch mentioned for not one, but two head coaching jobs in 2 months. The first one, Washington State, where he was the defensive coordinator for Mike Leach. He flipped that defense around from one of the worst in the country into a top 25 defense that was giving up like 20 points a game and was getting 20 takeaways. And he had Hercules Mata'afa, who's 6'2", 250 pounds, playing defensive tackle, turned him into an All-American out there in Pullman. I mean, what's in Pullman? You are, if you're there, but that's about it, man. And understanding that he did the stint at Ohio State, people were like, yo, our safety sucked and the defense was garbage. You guys can have Alex Grinch. We're like, we'll take him because we realized what everybody else realized. As soon as you got Greg Schiano up out the paint, up off the blacktop, you bring in Jeff Hafley and you take him off of Schiano difficulty and you got a world-beating defense out there at Ohio State. Chase Young, Malik Harrison, Baron Browning, Jordan, Sean Wade. My goodness, dude, you had hitters out there. And what happens if Oklahoma can get them same type of hitters on the defense? Know what I mean? Because the thing that Oklahoma fans are going to tell you, like, yeah, cool, five-star offensive recruits, but where are the defensive recruits, dog? Where's the five-star defensive tackles? Tell you, they at Bama, they at Georgia, they at LSU, they at Clemson. What if Oklahoma could get some of those? And then on the flip side, you got people freaking out about Graham Harrell out in Los Angeles. Like, don't let Graham go! Look, I'm here to tell you, I'm not necessarily the dude to go stomp it for USC, because y'all are a major league city and y'all care about pro football. Y'all care about the Los Angeles Lakers and lately the Los Angeles Clippers. Don't y'all come to me like y'all care about USC. It took Reggie Bush, Matt Leinart, Dwayne Jarrett, and them going undefeated for y'all to give a good damn about USC. I'm not here for no USC football. I am here, however, for Graham Harrell, and I want him to be in a good situation, okay? Now, if he thought that Colorado was a good situation, he wants to be a Power 5 head coach, it's a good place to be. But he did turn down a job already as the offensive coordinator at Texas, let Mike Yurcich pick that job up, and he turned down the opportunity to coordinate defense or to coordinate offense at Philadelphia for Doug Peterson. You understand? You know what time it is. And then they released a video where Graham Hill was like, yo, happy to be here, happy to sign my contract. And you got to know that Clay Helton was brought back. But he's brought back because he outkicked what everybody thought he was going to do. It was going to be real easy to fire that man. He didn't make a bowl. Not only make a bowl, he had him as a top 25 team before they got their butts handed to him in the Holiday Bowl by Iowa. And now we got people talking about Iowa being a top 10 team. That's another video altogether. But if you're Graham Harrell, you know that you just lay in the cut, you know, keep get your offense, continue to roll, and then they're going to hand you the job when they want to give Clay Helton a boot because he did the same thing that Alex Grinch did. He improved him by a touchdown in scoring. Michael Pittman was a finalist for the Biletnikoff Award in Graham Harrell's first year, and he did this with the fourth string quarterback, depending on how you want to look at it, right? Because JT Daniel was the dude, right? Then you had old boy going into the portal, coming out of Fresno State. Then you got Keaton Slovis getting the starts, and then when he go down, Matt Fink gonna go in there and start slinging the rock on people, just beating Utah down, all right? He did all of that with three different quarterbacks. What happens if he gets in a class that is actually worthwhile? What if they just lock up the Los Angeles area? Recruit it home. That's all I'm saying. But I understand. Somebody going to take this Colorado job. And I know that USC doesn't want to lose their offensive coordinator. I know that Oklahoma doesn't want to lose their defense coordinator. To which I also would add this. Colorado ain't that job. It's a better job than Washington State. It's on par with Michigan State, quite honestly. It's just as difficult to recruit to it. They got money. They got loot. You'll be paid well, but will you compete? It's Oregon's conference right now. Washington gonna be all right. You know, we know how people feel about Jimmy up there. We know that USC is trending in the right direction. We know Kyle Whittingham just continues to play outstanding defense and run the football. Arizona State on the come up. Those are all squads in the Pac-12. Colorado, you think you can hang? I don't think you can hang. Even if you bring in a guy like Alex Grinch to be your defensive coordinator and head coach, even if you bring like Graham Harrell be your offensive coordinator and head coach, it's going to be a problem. You understand what I'm saying? So when I look at this thing, I say, what would I need to win at Colorado? I would need not just myself, I'd need help. So the other part that Oklahoma would be very upset about is, you know, Alex Grinch brought in his own dudes to his defense. Guys that he coached with at Washington State, Roy Manning, Brian Odom, know what I mean? You know, maybe he want to take Calvin Thibodeau with him, to which some people be like, yeah, take Calvin. I'm not going to be mad about Calvin. Just brought in Jamar Cain out of Arizona State, a dude that's straight up from the mud out there, was recruiting from North Dakota State, drive 17 hours to Texas to go get players. I am an Oklahoman. And what Oklahomans really love is hustle and work ethic and dudes that's from the mud. And Alex Grinch is hustle and he's work ethic. And he's one of those Mount Union trios that have been so good as head coaches. Jason Campbell, Matt Campbell, Grinch, man. Now look, I understand. Perhaps you want a Power 5 coordinator that's on the way up. But my suggestion to Colorado is to go get Jason Campbell, like I just mentioned, out of Toledo. That man is absolutely outstanding, and he deserves an opportunity to be a Power 5 head coach. And if anybody would know how to build from the ground up and make it a winner in 2-3 years' time, a la Matt Campbell at Iowa State, it'd be Jason Campbell. Alex Grinch, I think, would consider the job, and if he turns it down, he's going to get one hell of a raise in June, because that's just how things work. See Steve Sarkisian turning down the job at Colorado when Nick Saban was like, here's your money. You want to be one of the highest paid assistants in college football? I'm going to make that happen, right? I'm going to make that happen. The other dude that I think the Colorado should seriously consider is, yes, my man Marcus Freeman out there at Cincinnati. See, he turned down the job as defense coordinator at Michigan State, but I'm saying the man need a Power 5 job. Or maybe, here's the thing. Perhaps you let Jason Campbell be Colorado's head coach. Then Marcus Freeman can come over there to Toledo and light it up. I love me some Marcus Freeman. I love me some Jason Campbell. I like Alex Grinch, but I want him to get a for real Power 5 job. And while Colorado has some tradition, it ain't got the tradition. And while Colorado is a Power 5 squad, you have about four dudes that you got to go out and beat. Just start with Oregon, Washington, Arizona State, USC. Okay? You think you can get it done, if you think you're the man to turn around out there in Boulder, then by all means, go take the job. But don't take it thinking it's going to be easy. All right. It for me. That was